आपको यार शेर हो एकदम फेविकॉल इज टेकिंग ऑल ऑफ दिस एंड पुटिंग इट इन देयर बॉटल्स विद हां
मल्टीस्ट्राडा मीट ट्रेन ट्रेन मीट मल्टीस्ट्राडा
Okay then, let's do this. This is the Ducati Multistrada 950S. It's truly one of my most feared motorcycles. In fact, it's been on my no-ride list since like freaking 2016. But I guess I want that to change today.
Another motorcycle and another little road trip. हम चल पड़े हैं आज की सुबह to a very very cute little town outside of Bombay. About 3 hours from Bombay. This is why I like to leave my house super early in the morning because I don't like getting stuck at Dahisar, which is from anything fast, like this whole FASTag thing that has been introduced by the road, whatever, toll authorities of India, NHAI, whatever it is, dude, that it's far from fast. It's a big farce, if anything. And usually I'm not one of those people who's sitting out and bitching people out, but god damn it. Like, if you have to leave your house super, super early in the morning just because you don't want to get stuck at a toll, how ridiculous is that? Now I think what I can do is do my thing. Let the bike do its thing. Yes. Now this is a bad road. I'm loving it. I'm not ripping because there's trucks and all ahead. I don't want to go straight into one. What lovely roads, yeah, amazing. क्या बात है, मजा आ जाता है ऐसा राइड करने में. वाटर क्रॉसिंग, what suspension this thing has, man, it's magic. Woo! Absolutely freaking loving it.
Goes the backstory. A Ducati instructor put me on this guy's bigger brother at World Ducati Week in Italy 5 years ago. While I was obsessing over its sheer size and freaking myself out, he simply started the bike and sent me off. That's where the shit show began in front of a massive crowd of Ducati motorheads. I couldn't get the bike to stop because my feet, they weren't anywhere close to the ground. And that's when I said to myself, boss, this one's not for you. Just stay the hell away, man. Why must you have to ride everything?
Seriously, bro, what's going on here? Ask for a multi-starter, didn't you, Priyanka?
Okay, so puddles like this, not very scary, but we're in a bit of a swampy region now, trying to get to the place that we're staying at. And that whole section ahead looks really, really cakey, swampy, slippery, slidily, everything. And as you know, I'm terrible at the off-road bit. So, yeah, man. I don't know how I could do this. Let's try. Oh my God, I think I've reached. There's chikus everywhere. Okay, so Dahanu is known for its chiku orchards, which go on for like miles together. In fact, Suraj is going to just like point the camera that way. This forest goes on for like ever. And we were just talking to Rajesh bhai right now. Rakesh bhai or Rajesh bhai? Ramesh! Rajesh bhi nahi, Rakesh bhi nahi. Ramesh! Maine aapka naam hi bigad diya. So, ye kitna dur tak किलोमीटर वाइज कितना दूर तक जाएगा?
कम से कम 3 किलोमीटर तक लग जाएगा।
क्या बात कर रहे हो? हाँ। तो 3 किलोमीटर तक ये चलता रहता है? हाँ। वाओ। और आप फिर क्या अंदर तक हाँ, जाते हो?
जाना पड़ता है हम लोग।
और सांप आप?
नहीं, सांप तो रहता है नहीं, किधर बाय चांस मिल जाता चले जाता।
हाँ, क्योंकि आपको देख के मेरे को मैं यहाँ पे पूरा बूट वूट पहन के आई हूँ कि भाई मैं चिकू निकालूंगी, पर प्रॉपर बूट पहन के, क्योंकि यहाँ पे बहुत सांप है। और आप तो चप्पल में हो, आप तो यार शेर हो एकदम।
ऐसा कुछ नहीं।
निकालू चिकू, खाएगा तू?
खाएंगा
ना। चल रही हूँ चिकू, हम नीड टेक आउट। ओके, ऑसम। So I'll just use the multi only, and for the fact that it's nice and tall, so I can nicely climb. So no, ये तो पके हुए नहीं है, ये सब बच्चे हैं सारे। इसको निकाल दूँ? चलेगा? Guys, my first chikku. मैंने इसको उगाया नहीं, मैं सिर्फ खाऊंगी और निकालूंगी, क्योंकि जॉय है उसमें। So this thing like releases this weird sap, of course, most fruiting plants do that. But legit, man, I think Fevicol is taking all of this and putting it into their bottles, because this is proper Fevicol. Like, look at this. You seeing this? Can you see this? Ah, look at that. Anyway, if you can see, we have nicely collected a lot of chikus. Ye kitne kg honge? 15 kg, bro. 15 kgs we have got in this basket, out of which I have collected only very few. But anyway, I have got my fill of chikus, and now I'm going to head to the never-ending beaches of Dahanu, which is apparently they're very non-commercial, and they're just really, really pretty. And I'm really looking for some me time. So I'll see you there. Chikuwala!
Oh, where are we going? What the hell? Dude, what the hell? Where is he going? Sheldon! Holy shit, where are we going? Oh my God, are you serious? Is this an actual legit road? Dude, that's literally where the train stops, man. This is nuts. This is so cool. Guys, are you seeing how close I am to the train tracks?
Okay, guys, after picking chikus, I was on my way to the beach, and the way out of where I'm living is literally like this, okay? There is literally no road, and you have to freaking touch a train to get back onto the main road. Where in India do you see this? This is such an old school scene going on. Like, Bombay, you will never even get to go this close to a train unless, of course, you're sitting inside it. But I've gotten to bring the Multistrada this close. Multistrada meet train, meet Multistrada. And this is just like an ajuba to me. I am touching a train while I'm passing by on my bike. If you've seen something like this, please tell me in comments. I really want to know and I want to visit. Bye, bhaiya. Okay, so the three things that I would kind of point out when it comes to this bike after riding it for the last 2 days that kind of scare me even now are definitely, I'm going to put it together, weight and height. So the weight of this thing is about 230 kgs with a 90% tank of fuel, and this is a 20 liter tank. So essentially this makes it super top heavy. Let me show you. Okay, I'll have to do this like that actually. Yeah, so I was saying that it makes this bike super top heavy. If you can see it, if I have to turn it around right now also, you will see that problem, that difficulty in turning the bike around, especially in an off-road adventure space. Not so much on the main road. Definitely so because of the height. Now, if you see the seat height, it's about 840. It's about 840 millimeters. And today, while having to take U-turns in Dahanu, especially on the busy streets, I was having massive trouble, man. For instance, this morning, I took about 20 minutes outside of where we were living to turn the bike around. So it was standing like this and I had to turn it like this. But the whole patch over there was just full of kichad and gravel and rain, water, everything mixed together. And dude, pushing and pulling this bike it's quite a task, especially if it's not something you do very often. And then there's traffic. Now, to take something as massive as this in traffic is awesome if you're a seasoned enduro adventure rider, which I am far from, because from the side you will just go like, all of you fuckers in traffic can just sit, I will go from the side over whatever, I'll fly through, no problem. I am not that person. When there is a traffic jam ahead of me, I try to go out the side, but I am not going to do the whole pavement jumping and shit. That's not me at all. The problem with this is, A, because it's a Ducati, it heats up. So that's one big issue that happens. And then when you're not a very tall rider and you have to keep putting your feet down in traffic, so you have to stop, you have to keep stopping and waiting. And that doesn't make it fun to ride a massively big bike like this. And then there's the open roads. I mean, dude, this is such a breeze. It's an actual breeze to ride on the road because you just... It takes you, you know, you and it's got that power when you want to just sift through all the trucks on the road and you're on the highway. You reach 150 like that and you don't even realize, you look at your speedo and you're like, oh my god, shit, what when did I reach that speed? And especially when you like open the throttle after a point, you like open the throttle like that rawness of that Ducati engine, it's beautiful. I loved riding this on the road. I loved coming to Dahanu on this. But I definitely have a long way to go when it comes to riding off-road / adventure rides. And I have a ton to learn. So yeah, I'm gonna keep at it and let's see where this road takes me. Okay guys, train to nikal gayi, par kya hua, jo lari chuti, you still can subscribe to my channel. Subscribe, I say, please. Subscribe, like the video. We put in a lot of effort into bringing these motorcycles and traveling and putting our own money and resources into making content so that you will like it and share it with your friends. To itna to kar hi sakte ho na. Subscribe kar lo, kyunki 100K bahut bahut paas mein hai. Yeah. And aur kya karna tha? Sab suraj kya ho? मॉडल्स कमेंट ना, हाँ कमेंट कर लो, कमेंट कर लो, प्लीज टेल अस व्हाट यू थिंक ऑफ, व्हाट यू थॉट ऑफ दिस होल ट्रेन थिंग दैट जस्ट हैपेंड राइट नाउ, एंड व्हाट यू थॉट ऑफ द बीचेस ऑफ द हानू, एंड मेनली व्हाट यू थॉट ऑफ दिस ब्रिलियंट ब्रिलियंट डुकाटी. वेटिंग टू हियर फ्रॉम यू. सी या.